Violent clashes in the U.S. at a white supremacist rally. The governor of Virginia now declaring a state of emergency. Mounting tensions over North Korea. U.S. President Donald Trump once again talking tough. And later, a rare look inside Pyongyang. Meet a woman who went undercover to teach English to the children of North Korea's elite. Hello, I'm Lynda Kinkade. Welcome to CNN Newsroom. Right now, we are monitoring violent clashes in a typically quiet and progressive college town nestled in the mountains of Charlottesville, Virginia. Demonstrators from the white nationalist movement are facing off against counter-protesters at a huge rally dubbed Unite the Right. It was organized after the city voted to rename a city park and remove a statue of the Confederate Civil War General Robert E. Lee. Virginia's governor has declared a state of emergency, even calling in the National Guard. We are getting reports of several arrests and injuries, though no numbers have been confirmed at this time. Well, joining me now on the phone is Heidi Beirich, the director of the Southern Poverty Law Center's Intelligence Project. Heidi, your organization has said this could be the largest hate gathering of its kind in decades in the U.S. Describe what we're seeing.
Yeah, well, I mean, we have hundreds and hundreds of people that make up white supremacist groups in the United States, as well as armed militiamen who have been clashing in a park in Charlottesville with anti-fascist protesters. We haven't seen this many white supremacists in one location literally in more than 15 years. And to have hundreds of these people in one place at the same time representing dozens of organizations is extremely unique.
And certainly looking at the pictures, they came well prepared. They've got shields, they've got batons, they've got helmets and goggles. Surely some of those things are banned from these sort of protests.
Well, look, they came looking for a fight. And for those of us like me who have spent the last several weeks monitoring their online communications and social media, it was clear that they were going to show up in this way. And that's why we had talked to law enforcement in advance about what they might see. I mean, this movement right now is about as energized and as emboldened as it's ever been in the United States in the modern era. And they are perfectly willing to brawl over their views, as we're seeing on the streets of Charlottesville today.
And even last night, we heard those chants, one nation, one people, end immigration. The U.S. Mm-hmm. president hasn't spoken about this rally so far. Is the president fueling this at all? Is he uniting the far right?
Look, Donald Trump's role in this is very important. He has emboldened these sectors of American society with his racist comments about Mexicans, his tweets from white supremacist accounts, his unwillingness to speak out against hate crimes or domestic terrorism coming from white supremacist sectors. So this movement not only loves Donald Trump, but feels like they're finally part of the political process, and he has done little to disabuse them of that notion. You know, the Southern Poverty Law Center has called on the Trump administration many times to denounce white supremacist ideas, and they've been very, very reluctant to do that, and we've yet to hear from the president today on this front.
And some of these white supremacists have openly supported the president. We saw those rallies that they held even during the campaigning leading up to last year's election, saluting Donald Trump even before he became president. Do you think that's partly why he hasn't even responded today? Could that be a reason that he wants their support?
Well, I mean, look, given that he has been so reluctant to speak out, you know, with the rash of hate crimes that happened after the election, for example, and to denounce white supremacist ideas and supporters, right? I mean, he was even reluctant to denounce probably the most well-known white supremacist in America, former Klansman David Duke, during the campaign. So at some point, you have to start thinking that this is a calculated move to not distance himself from these people, right? And certainly for the white supremacists, many of the leaders that are in Charlottesville today, they view Donald Trump's administration and some of his staffers like Steve Bannon as being supporters of theirs. In other words, you know, at least wink, wink and nod, nod to their ideas and try to keep them in the fold. So, you know, this is all the more reason why the Trump administration should forcefully denounce these ideas. It's not just that they're heinous ideas, which they obviously are, but he also needs to play a role in tamping down the kind of violence that we're seeing today in Virginia.
Hi, Heidi Beirich, really good to get your perspective and analysis today. Thank you very much for your time.
Thanks for having me.